Rishi Sunak has said no further action will be taken against Minister Mark Spencer after an investigation cleared him of breaching the rules over the sacking of Tory colleague Nusrat Ghani. In his investigation into alleged Islamophobia, Sir Laurie Magnus said it was not possible to determine what the then Chief Whip said to Ms. Ghani in two 2020 meetings. 1748, June 4, 2023, MACAD TV. Investigation clears former Chief Whip Mark Spencer over sacking of Muslim Tory MP Nusrat Ghani. 1750, June 4, 2023, MACAD TV. The Prime Minister's ethics advisor had been looking into claims by the former Conservative minister that she lost her job in a reshuffle because of her Muslim faith. 1751, June 4, 2023, MACAD TV. Rishi Sunak has said no further action will be taken against Minister Mark Spencer after a probe could not establish whether he told a female Tory MP she had been sacked because of her Muslim faith. However, an investigation by the Prime Minister's ethics advisor, Sir Laurie Magnus, identified some shortcomings in Mr. Spencer's behavior towards Ms. Ghani. Ms. Ghani said in response to the report that there was no criticism or doubt expressed regarding my version of events. Others will have to explain the report, noting the omissions, shortcomings, incomplete information, inaccurate briefings and claims implied without evidence in their actions and story, she said. Sir Laurie had been investigating claims made by Ms. Ghani that she was sacked. 1751, June 4, 2023, MACAD TV. She also said there were concerns she wasn't loyal to the party because she did not do enough to defend it against allegations of Islamophobia. In the immediate aftermath of Ms. Ghani's comments, Mr. Spencer, the former chief whip who is now an environment minister, identified himself as the whip in question but denied her claims. 1752, June 4, 2023, MACAD TV. He described her allegations as completely false, adding, I consider them to be defamatory. I have never used those words attributed to me. Some shortcomings. In his investigation into the alleged Islamophobia, Sir Laurie said it was not possible to determine what the then Chief Whip said to Ms. Ghani in two 2020 meetings. As Chief Whip, Mr. Spencer was responsible for enforcing discipline among MPs. However, Sir Laurie identified some shortcomings in how Mr. Spencer responded to Ms. Ghani's concerns, including that he failed to invite a witness to one of the meetings on March 4, 2020. He also criticized Mr. Spencer for providing Boris Johnson, the then Prime Minister, who vowed to look into Ms. Ghani's claims, with incomplete information by failing to M. 1753, June 4, 2023, MACAD TV, however, he added that it was not possible to conclude absolutely that such comments were not made, but again reiterated that he had found no evidence of comments of the nature described by Ms. Ghani being attributed in her case. I do not believe, when considered with the inconclusive evidence from the first two parts of this investigation, that the shortcomings identified in Mr. Spencer's response to Ms. Ghani's concerns amount to a clear failure to meet the standards set out in the ministerial code. However, there are procedural and pastoral lessons to be drawn from this investigation which should be considered by those engaged in handling ministerial appointments and dismissals in future. It is important that all those involved are sensitive to, 1753, June 4, 2023, MACAD TV, the impact of what they say, consider carefully the content of their messaging, including the manner in which it is delivered, and respond promptly and sympathetically to queries or concerns. Not acceptable in any way. Ms. Ghani said in a statement, we all serve at the Prime Minister's choosing and there is no shame in a political career ending. But to be told your faith and identity is the reason for it cannot be acceptable in any way. The impact of being told this was devastating and my motivation in pursuing the complaint was to ensure it wasn't buried, but that it ended with me so that no other colleague would have to endure anything similar. I would like to thank the Prime Minister and Sir Laurie for publishing the report after 3 years. As I said last year, my party is better and bigger than this whole sorry episode which has only been bearable due to the support of so many Conservative colleagues. 1753, June 4, 2023, MACAD TV. Rishi Sunak also thanked Sir Laurie for the report, but added, in the absence of clear evidence, it would not be right to take further action. I have spoken to both ministers and encouraged them to heed your advice to pull together in the finest tradition of public service. Sir Laurie's investigation puts an end to months of delays after Ms. Ghani initially made her claims in January last year. The delays were caused partly by the resignation of Sir Laurie's predecessor, Lord Christopher Guyte, in June 2022 over issues relating to Partygate. Mr. Johnson was then without an ethics advisor for a number of months until Mr. Sunak became Prime Minister. Mr. Sunak appointed Sir Laurie in December after coming under criticism for delays to the process, and he took over the investigation in February.
I don't think there is anywhere else that Nuzghani in theory could go. I guess this now becomes a question politically whether Nuzghani is happy that enough has been looked into, whether this matter has been taken seriously enough. At the time when these allegations first surfaced, she says that she was worried that essentially the government wasn't taking these accusations seriously enough. And remember, accusations of Islamophobia within the Conservative Party are nothing new. There has been several of them floating around for quite a while now, and several concerned voices even within the party talking about whether the party has really gripped the issue with the firmness that it should. This will now clearly be a decision for Nuzghani about whether she is satisfied with the outcome of this and whether she is satisfied with Rishi Sunak's handling of this. I think the tone of the letter from Rishi Sunak suggests that maybe she is, because Rishi Sunak suggests that he has spoken to both of them and urged them to pull together in the finest traditions of public service. But I think a lot will hinge on what Nuzghani says now. Obviously, if she feels so strongly about this investigation and whether it has gone far enough in her view, she would, of course, have the option of resigning her post from the government, albeit at the moment that doesn't seem to be on the table. But I think really a lot hinges on what Nuzghani says now in response to this investigation and in response to what Rishi Sunak has done in him saying that he doesn't think that any further action is required.
Rob, thank you. Rob Powell, the latest there on that breaking news.